Welcome to this class. Today we are going to balance this reaction. This is sodium carbonate, this is water, this is sodium hydroxide, and this is carbon dioxide. To balance this reaction, at first we have to draw a table like this. So now we need to count the number of atoms. So in the left hand side we have sodium, which is 2, then we have carbon, which is 1, we have oxygen, which is 3. Then here we have one more oxygen, right, in water. So basically we are getting 4 oxygen. Then here we have hydrogen, which is 2. In the right hand side we have sodium, which is 1. Then we have oxygen, here 1, and here 2. So basically we are getting 3 oxygen. Then we have hydrogen, which is 2. Sorry, which is 1 here, right? Hydrogen 1 1. Then we have carbon, which is 1. Okay, to balance this reaction we have to balance the number of sodium, carbon, oxygen and hydrogen from both sides of this reaction. Sodium here 2, but here 1. So to balance the sodium, what can you do? You can simply multiply here by 2, that gives you 2. The rule is that if you multiply by something, that something must come before the atom. So 2 will come before the sodium. So I have to place here 2. So the number of sodium is 2. The number of oxygen will be changed here. So you have to change here 2 oxygen, right? Then 2 plus 2, that gives you 4. So let me update. 4. Look, now the number of hydrogen will be also sent, so 2. So we have to write here 2. Now check. In the left hand side we have two sodium, then in the right hand side we have 2 sodium, right? We have 1 carbon here, we have 1 carbon here, then we have 4 oxygen here, we have 4 oxygen here, then we have 2 hydrogen. So look, everything is balanced. So you can say that this is the balanced reaction, right? If I say you that what is the balanced chemical equation, then you can change this arrow sign by equal sign. So thank you for viewing this video. Be well.